Thank you for watching Grandpa's videos.
In this video, we're going to add an IoT device to our basic wireless network that we created in our last lab. So from the End Devices menu, we're going to insert a server. So we're going to click on End Devices, go to Server, and then put that onto the workspace here. And I've been working with this, so it says Server 1. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this and change this to Server 0. Next, we're going to wire this to the wireless router. And we're going to come down here and click Connections. Click on copper straight through. On the server 0, we're going to put that into the fast Ethernet 0 slot. And on the wireless router, we're going to put that into Ethernet 1. And if we give it a few minutes, it will come up green, or we can fast forward time. And now we've got green lights, so it is working. On the server, we're going to click there. And then we're going to bring up the config tab. And we're going to go down to fast Ethernet 0. And we're going to turn on DHCP, so that the wireless router will give us a DHCP address. And in this case, it gave us 192.168.5.102. And so now I'm going to make a note up here beside the server so I have that IP address listed. So it's 192.168.5.102. Now on the server services tab, we're going to come and look down on the IoT services. And we're going to select that, and we're going to turn on the registration server. Next, we're going to click on the desktop tab, and we're going to scroll down to IoT monitor. Now we want to put in our server address, and it is not 25.1, it's 5.102. So we can just put in 5.102 there. And we're going to click login, but it's going to say that we have the wrong username or password because we do not have an account yet set up. So what we're going to do is go ahead and click on sign up now, and we're going to create a username of admin and a password of admin, and we're going to create. And then now we've got our devices listed. Of course, we have not added any devices at this point, so nothing is going to show up. Next, we're going to go on End Devices. So we're going to click on End Devices, click on Home, and we're going to scroll over to the light, and we're going to put the light onto the workspace. Now, the light currently has a wired Ethernet port and not a wireless interface, so we're going to need to change that at the bottom of the light's configuration window. So we're going to click on the light. Then we're going to click on the IO config tab, or we're going to make sure it says PTIOTNM1W. If it doesn't have that, then that's what you want to put on there. Next, we're going to click on the config tab, go down to wireless 0, and here is where we want to put in our configuration, our SSID and our WPA2 PSK and our passphrase. And I'm going to make a note up here beside the wireless router of what our SSID and our password is, and then we'll continue on. So now we're going to set our SSID to what our wireless router's SSID is. And in this case, it's Happy Vintage. We're going to select WPA2-PSK. We're going to put our passphrase in of Network Plus. And I know up on the note, it's showing a space in there between Network and NetW and Orc Plus, but it's just Network Plus. The note on the size is just messing up there. And then we're going to make sure that it's set on AES. And then when we close this tab, it should make a connection. And so now we have our connection from our light to our wireless router, and it should be communicating to our IoT here in just a moment. So now we need to make sure that our light is talking to our IoT server. So we're going to click on Settings in the left-hand pane. And then we're going to scroll down to IoT Remote Server. And then we're going to put in the server address, and that is the 192.168.5.102. with a username of admin and a password of admin. We're going to click connect. It should say that it's connecting. Next, we're going to come up here to the server. And if we click on desktop services for IoT services, that should still be open because I did not close it. I just minimized it. And then now we should be able to see our light, and we should be able to dim it and turn it off. Turn it off, turn it on, turn it to dim. Okay, so now we can close these, and we have our working IoT devices on here. And the assignment in my class is to add one more IoT device. So what you'll want to do is just come down here and select another device, like a ceiling fan or a Bluetooth speaker. And then what you'll do, for example, like on this Bluetooth speaker, is just come down on here, go to the config, scroll down to the remote server, put in the server address, 192.168.5.102, put in your username and password, connect it, wireless interface. So we need to go to wireless zero and we need to put in happy vintage. Put in our password of network plus. Then we can go over here to physical, check to make sure it's turned on. It is. And now we've got our connection there. And now we can come back over to our server. And it should connect. Let's refresh it. Let's refresh it since we got a new since our IP connected. And then come back over here. And there we go. So now we've got our Bluetooth speaker connected and our light connected. And if you have any questions, you can email me from It's Inside My Course. Or if you have any questions from YouTube, you can find my connect. Just leave a comment below on the video and I'll be able to answer you on there. Or you can email me, find my email address on my YouTube channel and email me if you have any questions on that. Hope you have a great day. And remember, be excellent to each other.
Thank you for watching Grandpa's videos.